Now we will write a program which reads a positive integer n, then calculates and shows the sum of the even numbers, which are less than or equal to n. Then we will modify this program to get the sum of the odd numbers. So as usual, I'm taking the number from the user, and right now, we have to iterate over the numbers that are less than or equal to n. So we're going to use a loop. So as we know, we want to add the even numbers. So we can start from I equals 2, and the condition is I is less than or equal to n, and then we can add 2 to I. So this loop will start from 2, then we will add 2, so we'll get 4, then 6, then 8. So we are getting the even numbers. And whenever this condition is no longer true, we will get out of the loop. So in this loop, all we have to do is say sum plus equals I, and we will get our solution. So let's define this integer over here. So integer sum is equal to 0. And outside of the loop, let's print our number. So printf sum. So build and run this program. Let's say we want 4. So press enter and we get 6 because 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. Let's have another example. Let's say 8. So as you can see, we get 20. 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 is equal to 20. Perfect. So in order to get the odd numbers, the first odd number we have is 1. So now we started from 1. The next odd number is 3. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Then 3 plus 2 is equal to 5, and so on. So over here, this will remain the same. And this will give us the sum of the odd numbers inside sum. So let's try this program, build and run. So let's say our number is 8, and we get 16. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. And this is correct. So let's look at another solution. Let's say we will increment I normally. And over here, I will say sum even. And also we'll have another variable called sum odd. So we are going to add the even numbers inside this variable, and we will add the odd numbers inside this variable over here. Then outside the loop, we will print these two variables. So we will print sum even, and we will also print sum odd. So this loop iterates over all the numbers that are less than or equal to n. So inside this loop, we are going to test. If I is even, then we will add it to this variable. And if it is odd, then we will add it to this variable. So let's do that. We will use an if statement. So if I modulo 2 is equal to 0, this means that I is an even number. So what we'll do is that sum even plus equals I. And if this condition is not true, so I is an odd number. So we will say else sum odd plus equals I. And this solves our question. So let's build and run. Let's enter 8. And as you can see, we get the same results from before. This over here is the sum of even numbers, and this over here is the sum of the odd numbers. And I want to say one thing. This if statement is inside this for, and this statement is inside this if. And this else belongs to this if over here, and this statement is inside this else. So we do not need braces over here. Perfect. So I'll see you in the next exercise.